closer to read will be coming from John the 12th chapter. We're just going to read two verses. We ought to still be able to give God the praise. John 12, verse 12 and verse 13. On the next day, much people that were come to the feast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, they took palms, they took branches of palm trees, and went forth to meet him, and cried, "Hosanna, blessed is the King of Israel that cometh in the name of the Lord." I hope your Bible read like that. We want to talk from this subject here, going beyond Palm Sunday. Going beyond Palm Sunday. My brothers and sisters, it was at Passover times that Jews came from the end of the earth to Jerusalem to observe at least one Passover in Jerusalem. And at the Passover time, the Jews would celebrate the deliverance of their ancestors from the Egyptian bondage. And during Passover, the Sadducees and the Roman guard was concerned about keeping order away at the right moment to burst forth. Now, I don't care what you might think about this, but no wonder Paul said that when I would do good, evil is always right there. Amen. Am I right about it? Yeah, and during the Passover, the Sadducees and the Roman guard was concerned about keeping order, awaiting for the right moment to burst forth. And according to John's account, it was during Passover that Jesus had come nearby to Bethel to see about his good friend Lazarus, because Jesus had raised Lazarus from the dead. Yeah. Am I right about it?
Amen.
Yes, sir. And news about this great miracle had reached all the way to Jerusalem.
Yes.
Yeah, some of the people were curious, and some was well-wishers. I went to greet Jesus and his followers. Jesus was riding on a brand new donkey that had never been ridden before. And he was received like a conquering king, and some even cut palm branches and they waved them in the air and spread them along the road. Am I right about it? And others spread their garments on the road, and multitude was shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who cometh in the name of the Lord. He is the King of Israel."
Yes, yes.
Now, Matthew Gospel, it tells us that Jesus entered Jerusalem. There was much rejoicing, and the whole city was moved. Now, you know, this had to be a very significant day for the disciples who had left it all to follow Jesus. If the writer of the gospel had put down their pen and ended their account with the Palm Sunday triumphant entries, we would have had a nice, very good picture here. Trouble-free success story. If the gospel ended with Palm Sunday,
they did not stay with him. Church, it's easy to be part of a Palm Sunday crowd. Everybody likes a one that is going some places. Am I right about it? The multitude was singing praises to Jesus. That was no risk, no inconvenience, no sacrifice, and no demand was placed upon their obedience, and no request was being made for money. Church, it's easy to proclaim Hosanna when everything is going good. It's easy to proclaim Hosanna when you know you got some money to carry you over to the next week. But what about when your pockets get dry? Can you still give God the thanks and the praise for what he's already done for us? Yes. You see, this Palm Sunday story does not tell the whole story. Christians who walk with Jesus on that Palm Sunday, when things are going well, everybody is happy. Is that right?
Yes,
but you see, we miss out on the real victory. People won't go beyond Palm Sunday when things is bad. Am I right about it? But whenever you don't go beyond Palm Sunday, you miss out on the ecstasy of the gospel. Now, to really understand who Jesus was and what he was about and what he can really do for you, in you, with you, and through you, you must go beyond Palm Sunday.
Yeah.
People of God, Palm Sunday marked the beginning of Jesus' last week of earthly ministry before his death. Y'all hear what I said? In the gospel here of John, Palm Sunday occurred in chapter 12, and his gospel does not end in chapter 21. Yeah. But John's gospel will be left out if he stopped, if we stop at Palm Sunday. When we go beyond Palm Sunday in our attitude, we must go beyond Palm Sunday in our talking about religion. We must go beyond Palm Sunday in our devotion to Christ. We must go beyond Palm Sunday in our living in the power of the Holy Spirit. We must follow Jesus on that Monday after Palm Sunday. When he went into the temple, he saw the merchants. They was buying and selling. They was cheating and lying. And you know what he done? He drove them out of his father's house. If you go beyond Palm Sunday, we gotta come to grips with the imperfection of the church. So many times I've seasoned Christians as well as new Christians have become discouraged because they see so much of the same behavior and attitude that is in the church as we see in the world. And in are so many Christian folk. But I just wish that the church as we you and I stray away from where we ought to be, Jesus has a way of shaking us up. Y'all hear that?
Yeah.
Don't you tell me COVID-19 don't make you wake up. Some of you are praying like you ain't never prayed before.
Amen.
God has a way of bringing us back in line. Is that right? You see, we must go beyond Palm Sunday and follow Jesus on Tuesday. When they criticized him and tried to discredit his teaching. On that Palm Sunday, I want everybody to know that we can't allow a Tuesday devil to steal our Palm Sunday spirit. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
All right.
Listen, we can't lose our religion over critics. You're going to have them.
Amen.
What we got to do is keep going anyway.
Amen.
Keep giving God the thanks and the praise.
Glory
be to God. But like Jesus, we got to stand on God's word and hold on to the perfection of our faith.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Amen.
Listen. On Wednesday, Judas, one of Jesus' chosen disciples, made a contract with the authorities to betray our Lord. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Listen, when you go beyond Palm Sunday, every church, every family, every circle of friends, they have a Judas in there somewhere.
Yeah.
Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Don't you think that you can come to church and Judas ain't sitting up in here?
Come on.
Amen. They either sitting up or sitting in front of you, sitting behind you.
That's right.
Sometimes, listen, those who do us the greatest harm are those of who not without, but those from within the church.
Amen.
Am I right about it? For every Judas who betray us, thanks be to God that we got somebody that care for us to lift our spirit. For every Judas who dig a ditch for us, there is always somebody that's telling us, don't you give up now. This race is not given to the swift, to the strong.
Be
Tendency to see God everywhere. But I'm going to tell you something.
the point that you can't see God. God sees you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm reminded of when Jesus told his disciples, get on a boat and go to the other side. Oh, they was obedient to what God's word said.
Yes.
And that's what you and I got to do. We got to be obedient to God's word. And when they got out there, a storm came. Hallelujah. COVID-19 ain't just broke out. It's been around a long time. This COVID-19 got us all in a storm.
Oh, yeah.
Got us locked up without a home. Scared to go see mom and dad if we just called. But let me tell you something. Sometimes when this storm is raging in our lives, we can't see Jesus. And you know, and when Jesus came to his disciples out there on the wall, guess what they said? They said it was a ghost. Let me tell you something. If you're a child of God, you ought to be able to recognize the hand of God in this COVID-19.
Amen.
Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
Hallelujah. You ought to be able to recognize God. But I found out that so many of us Christians, we are going around telling what the governor said, but we ain't telling what God said.
That's right.
Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
And you remember words. What the governor said and can't remember John 3:16.
My Lord.
I'm telling the truth.
Yeah, you are.
But my brothers and sisters, as Jesus went to Young Palm Sunday, we got to go to Young Palm Sunday. We got to be able to see God at all times. And always remember, when you're in your valley, when you're in your storm, Jesus got the victory for you and I. Ain't it good? I think Sister Antoine sang that song. It's good to know Jesus. Hallelujah. We don't know what kind of condition we're going to get in before we leave this earth. COVID-19 might take my life, but this is one thing I can tell COVID-19. If you take my life, you're pushing me in the arms of Jesus. Just saved by grace.
Amen.
And Father God, if you will draw your hands for us while we go. God, we need you more than ever before in our lives. God, we ask you to help us to walk by faith and not by sight. We thank you now, God, for the Goodwill Church family. We thank you for those that's not of this fold. And God, we pray blessings over every minister, every pastor that is standing to declare your word. Because we know one day you're coming back looking for a church without a spot or wrinkle. And we want to hear you say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Come on in and enjoy. That'll be a time of no sickness, no sadness. No COVID-19, whatever disease might strike this earth, it ain't gonna strike us in heaven.
Yes.
Because nothing but the righteous shall save
you.
We thank you, my God, for your blessings. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Be blessed now.
Amen.
Amen. Now, Lord, we ask you to dismiss us from this place, but not from your presence. God, we love you. We thank you. Because you went beyond the palms.
Oh, yes.
And went all the way to the cross and died for our sins. And Father God, we have sent you as our personal Savior. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Oh!